Welcome to the Spiritual Roundtable, where we're about to break down, discuss, unpack, and challenge pretty much anything spiritual. Together, we're going to embark on a journey of unlocking spiritual potential through a ton of things like healing, balance, oneness, devil's advocate, and so much more. We always promise to give you what you need and only sometimes what you want. I'm your host, Erica M., Child of Balance, and here with me, my co-host is Miss Erin M., Tease of Wisdom 369. Today we were talking about the truth of authenticity and just how you have to be in full and utter alignment with your ness. Not sure if you are? Come join us and find out if you are or if you aren't. All right, so welcome in, and this is probably a great time for you to pull up a chair and get comfy. Because a large part of what we talk about today is actually going to be bringing awareness to some things that I feel like a large part of the collective doesn't actually take the time to realize is a problem in what we do as a culture, maybe, as a spiritual community. There's a large part of the community that wants to jump and skip a couple steps. And we just want to kind of quick and fast forward to the end. And I'm going to burst your bubble. Right now, there's no end. Everything's continuous. It never ends. There's no end goal, as much as our human experience and the people we're around like to make us think that there's an end goal and then all of a sudden we reach it and like straight euphoria. That's just not how it works. It's not how it happens. So you can push that load of garbage right out the window. And what we don't realize is that to get to what we believe is our dream, to manifest our dreams, our proverbial end goal, right? You our need to align with it. Yeah, our highest timeline. You need to align with it. In order to align with it, you need to have your ness. If you know me, you know what we do here. I call it your ness. It's your essence. It's your authenticity. You need to have that on board and you need to be working off of your authenticity at all times. Good, bad, indifferent, neutral, it doesn't matter. It should be stemming from you being in alignment with your authenticity. A lot of times when we skip steps, we don't realize that we're not actually functioning in an authentic way. We're not functioning in a way that is authentic to our soul, to our experience, to all the pieces and parts of ourselves. That's really important because it's the center of who we are and it is our ness. Our authenticity encompasses everything. Our past lives, our soul's knowledge, also our traumas and our dramas, our shadows, our shame, our anger, our sadness, our happiness, our euphoria. It's everything. It's not just the rosy, fun, you know, picture perfect things that look fantastic on the outside. It's not what we hope to achieve. It's not what we hope to be. It's what we are. It's what we are when we're not trying to be us. And that is 1,000% perfect, because the way it is packaged in the toxic side of spirituality is that you have to be this picture perfect. It's bullshit. It's bullshit. I'm not even going to finish the sentence because you already finished it in your head if you're listening to this. It's bullshit. The love and light community, bullshit. The community that tells you that, like, you know, you don't need to do all that and you could just, you know, yeah, you can, but you're not going to get your desired result if you skip the steps. And then you're going to be like, the manifestations don't work for me. Everybody else gets to manifest their dreams and I keep getting bullshit. It's because you are walking around projecting inauthentic bullshit. So therefore, what do you get? You get inauthentic bullshits for dreams back. And that's just the truth. The universe gives us what we are and what we are walking around pretending to be. Not what we want. So if you want the things you want, let me say again, if you want the things you want and you want them now, what you need to embrace is your authenticity. But there's a large misconception on exactly what your authenticity is. So pull up a seat, come sit down, and we're going to get all the way into authenticity and just what the fuck it is.
You know, I think the thing is that people often, like you said, they put things in boxes. They say it has to look a certain way. Your authenticity is not going to look like other people's. So it's literally like, stop the comparison game. Stop thinking that you have to do it this way, because just like you said, toxic spiritual community, you have to be this image, this embody this thinking, these constructs, these beliefs. Finding your authenticity is literally uncovering and unlearning and being willing to dissect everything that you're not. Because it's like you said, when you sit in a space where, and I'll just say what it is, if you're going to act fake as fuck, you're going to get fake as fuck experiences back. You're going to get a mass experience. You're going to get all of these things except for what you want, because you're just talking the talk and you're not walking the walk. It's literally just that simple. When your words and your actions don't meet, you are not in alignment. So the thing is, you know, when you start to dissect things, you have to take the notion or the concept of right and wrong out of it, because that right there is the first, like, I want to say, like, roadblock to your authenticity. And I don't mean right, wrong as in it has to look a certain way. It's that is rooted in judgment all by itself. Right, wrong is rooted in judgment. But then this is where you got to peel it back and dissect it, right? What is your belief system of right or wrong? What is your definition? Because what yours is and someone else's is not necessarily the same. So when you start dissecting these things, you know, dude, I know we say this quote all the time on multiple podcasts, but I just, like, I can't help but say it again because here we are. But who are you before the world told you who you had to be? It is that simple. But, you know, like we said, you were saying, everybody wants to skip the steps. Why is shadow work important? Why is this important? Why is that important? Because until you get to the foundation of who you built yourself thinking you had to be, you can't unlearn all of that to find out who you've actually always been. Your authenticity or your ness, I love that you call it ness, by the way, B. But, like, your ness has always been there. Your nest got muddied, it got skewed, it got a bias, it got all of these things that, like, you know, enveloped around it, but it's always been there. But you got to start with, you know, the deconstructing of the limiting beliefs. Like, why are you not worthy of something? Why are you waiting around for something? You know, I think I was just saying this earlier today, but, you know, when you decide you want to live your best life, your authentic life, right? You're not putting yourself on a timetable. I have to do this quickly, this, because that's now an expectation. That is now a comparison. What's going to happen if you don't? What is going to happen to you if you don't? You living your best life, like you said, it doesn't stop. When you reach one idea that you wanted to attain, now what's the next one? That idea of your very highest timeline, your highest timeline exists every day if you stay in the present moment. And it is literally a culmination of small choices. It's doing things that align and feel right for you, not other people. And you have to sit there and look at every single time you do something. If your gut decision is like, am I going to go do this today? And you're like, no. And then you go do that. You're being inauthentic to yourself. You're doing something that does not resonate for you. But that's why you kind of always have to go backwards to go forwards in your own personal spiritual journey or on your path to your, you know, living your best life. I'll just call it living your best life. Living your best life it's like you say, it's a working definition. Authenticity is a working definition because every moment you're given an opportunity to do things differently, to be who you truly are and not what you think you have to be.
And everybody's question, and I don't care who you are, you have asked it at one point or another, is, well, who am I? Well, who am I? What does that mean? And when we come to the spiritual community and we just separate it a little bit from, like, people who are just diving into their healing journey, right? Like, let's separate it, because usually the people who are skipping their steps are trying to skip their healing journey. Or we've healed one part and we're like, we're healed now. And then we go forward in, like, this big crescendo just to get swatted like a fly because something else comes up we need to deal with. There's a large part of that that goes with the, like, well, I want to find my purpose. What's my purpose in life? Where am I headed? What am I supposed to be doing? You You like, there's this notion, and I love it, and it's what you seek is also seeking you. And there's this part of your purpose that it's like, your purpose is not separate from you. Your purpose is you. Your purpose is the action behind you being you. And that's entirely a really important thing. It's your purpose is the physical action, the ripple effect that occurs when you continue to walk through the world being you. So the question is, you know, who am I? But it's not outside of you. It's what is everything that I am? The easiest way to find out what you are is to find out what you're not. Your authenticity lies in the center of your being. It is everything that you were dropped on the planet with. The second you, out of the womb, you were authentic. The second you took your first breath, you were authentic. Every life experience, every person, place, or thing you have come into contact with has shaped the character, your ego, your personality, your self-worth, your existence, and the physical plane, either in favor of your authenticity, or in one way, shape, or form, suppressing it, or some people call it masking it, or putting it in the shadows, breaking off and shamefully suppressing or neglecting it or shoving it down, bottling it up in one way, shape, or form. And then we pivot, is the way that I say it, or Key says move accordingly. We move accordingly. So if we do great things and we get great responses, we're going to keep doing those great things. If we do authentic things and we get bad responses, we're going to not do those authentic things. The key is part of your authenticity journey is realizing that how other people respond to your authenticity is not your problem. And if you are consistently around people who respond poorly to your authenticity, you're probably around the wrong people. And they're probably placed there for you to either A, level up, or to teach yourself something, for you to understand that it's not about compromising yourself to be around these people. But it's about finding where you fit. So taking that authenticity and going elsewhere. But sometimes it's easier to change ourselves because it's what we can control. But that's the kind of taking ownership and being like, how many times have we changed ourselves for people who weren't us? For situations that weren't us, that weren't in our highest, greatest good, that weren't doing all of these things. How many times have we edited ourselves or changed our path or made a different decision that went against who our nature of ourselves is, who what our essence actually is, what we plopped out the womb as? Well, you do that, let's just say you do it once a day in a small way. You do it once a day, 7 days a week. You've now done it 7 times in 1 week. You multiply that by 52 weeks in a year, holy poop, you've done it a lot. And then you're not alive just 1 year, because you're more than 1 year old if you logged on and listened to this podcast. Like, you're a whole lot older, like, not going to call you out for your age, but you're a whole lot older than that. Like, now we're saying 20, 30, 40, 50 years. 50 years of hundreds of pivots, with majority of them more than likely being against your authenticity, to please the ego so we blend in, because our authenticity makes us stand out. That's why it's authentic to us. And it's not the Gen Pop crowd. You know, I feel like you want to say something. I can feel it and see it. What's up?
Well, I've got a couple things to say. But, you know, when you're sitting there talking about, like, your the authenticity and the, it's your weirdness. Like, seriously. When you grew up and you were a kid, people called you weird. It's your weirdness. It's what you've buried since you were a little kid. And you put on the mismatched socks and you flew around, you know, with the pillowcase on your head. And all of the things that somebody made you feel you were out of place for doing. So when I say that, it makes me... This is where I was going while you saw my face. You were talking about how, you know, when you're around people, rhetorical question. You don't even have to piggyback off this one. How many people come into their spiritual path, their journey, their awareness, right? What is the one thing they want in the beginning? I want my soul fam. I want my tribe. I want all of this, right? And you go looking for shit again in the wrong places. Because sometimes on the toxic side of things, you have to fit in a box. So if you find yourself literally going from, I can't take this anymore, right? I need to do things differently. And you're so excited to dive in over here, right? Whatever over here is for you. And you find yourself early on, whether that's working with people, speaking with people, unpacking things with people, whatever you're doing to facilitate that growth for you, and you find you got to put a mask on, you find you can't speak your piece, you can't ask a question, you can't agree to disagree. Those are all little things that add up into you continuing to move in an inauthentic way.
Now, a word from our sponsors. If you are looking for a one-stop shop for all things spiritual, check out the website, www.childofbalance.com. We opened up a Get 5, Give 5 program. And it's all for referring friends and family. We know you guys do it. We want to say thank you because we are always seeing you send your trusted people our way. So visit the website and figure out how you can not only get $5 for doing it, but give $5 to your bestie. Visit www.childofbalance.com. There's no end date. We're just launching it now to say thank you. So if you want a one-stop shop for private spaces, spiritual guidance and assistance, mediumship, mentorship, private readings, shadow work assistance, it's all there. If you are looking for a free tree of knowledge where you can learn esoteric wisdoms, breath work, you can learn about yourself, cultures, spiritual hygiene, spiritual practices, spiritual traditions, and you can just learn about almost anything under the sun spiritual for 100% free, check out the website. And you should become a member. If you're not already a member, www.childofbalance.com. It's 100% free. It'll never cost you money. We would never charge you money. The website is about assistance and community. Take advantage of it, fam. It's a great place to go to unlock your spiritual potential. www.childofbalance.com. And there's like a large part of kind of just what you just said about people, you know, trying to find their soul family. But that is like, you can't miss what's for you in the universe. So if you sit in that knowing, because that's the truth, like you can't miss what's for you. Nope. It doesn't matter how long you had to live here to get it. It doesn't matter how many different turns you had to make. It's finding you. It doesn't matter if you had to go backwards, forward, up, down, left, right. You can't miss what's for you. So the goal is not to find what aligns with you. The nope. goal is to yeet everything that doesn't out the fucking way. Like, that is the goal. And that's the goal with everything in life. It's not, I need to find my people. It's nope. that when people come to me and they're not my soul family, it's being like, oh, mentally making that check. Like, oh, that don't align with me. And that's all it takes. But it's the recognizing of this aligns or it doesn't. But the only reason you know it aligns with you is if you know yourself. And knowing yourself is knowing your authenticity. Knowing yourself is being authentic. And everyone like will be like, well, in one way it's suppressed you or one way the... And that's true. But your authenticity is also the not rosy things. Your authenticity is also your anger. Mm-hmm. It's also your hurt. It's also your pain. It's also the shitty things you say about people. It's also like, that's also your authenticity, especially when you are living from your trauma still. Like, know that that is still your authenticity because it is a part of your shadow, because your traumas are your shadow. And it's only when we balance and readopt our shadow that our authenticity can shine in a balanced way, to where those little things don't hinder everything just as much. So it's like, it's not the rosy side of authenticity of being like, I'm so happy and I'm free and I'm quirky and I'm fun. That's fantastic. But like, for you to be that happy and for you to be that free and for you to be, you also have the capability of going the opposite height in depth in the lower frequency. You want to reach up to the cosmos, you have to have your roots all the way down in the ground. And it's the same thing. You want to be super happy, you have to be super sad. You want to be super cool, you have to be super a loser. Like, it goes both ways, but no, it's the truth. It goes both ways because you have to have both, because your authenticity will fluctuate up and down in the neutral zone, that gray area. That's where your balance comes from. If I take the loser part of you off the board, well, now you're not in balance. Now your cool is shot down to the ground and your scales are tipped. And usually when we're out of balance is when we start judging, labeling ourselves, is when we start placing ourselves in boxes, saying things are lesser than, and all of these other things that are limiting you expressing yourself in an authentic way. If it exhausts you to go through the day being authentic, you're lying to yourself, you're masking, it's not your authenticity.
Facts.
You need to come to terms with that. It, like, you can't be like, I'm just trying to be my authentic self and it's so exhausting. Then, bitch, that's not your authenticity. That is what you perceive authenticity to look like, because your ego got involved, because your brain got involved when your soul should have been in charge of that one. Like, your authenticity is your nest. It is your soul, and it is your soul paired with all of your personal life experiences this go around. It is everything. It is your shadows, your dramas, your traumas. It is all of it. It is your light connection. It is your hive mind. It is your oneness, bound energy. It is your limitless potential inside a vessel. That's your authenticity. So if it exhausts you to be you, then you're not being you, because you don't have to be anything other than that you are to be authentic. And that's in each and every moment of every day. But that also means that your authenticity is also a growing and working definition. So because it takes into account your shadows, your dramas, and all of your life experiences, the authentic you were 3 days ago is not the same authentic you are today, because you've had a whole lot of shit happen in those 3 days. And that's the truth. So if you are putting authenticity on a pedestal of perfection, of always being smiley, bubbly, happy, having the right answer, moving gracefully, because I hear that all the time. I want to be graceful and authentic. Sometimes authenticity looks like I just tripped down the stairs with a load of books. Like, oops, clumsy. Like, that's okay. Like, you know what I mean? Your authenticity doesn't always have to be prim and proper. Your authenticity can be messy, because your sadness is sometimes messy, because your anger is sometimes messy, because your shadow is sometimes messy. So it's like your humanness is imperfect. You are placed in an imperfect vessel to realize that you are perfect in your imperfections. So therefore, your authenticity is also imperfect. And you have to understand that it is because of its imperfections that make it divinely perfect. So you have to accept that. You have to adopt that idea and that philosophy and realizing that, oh my God, if I'm walking through being like, I just need to be my authentic self, you're looking at it wrong, because you are placing your authenticity as something outside of you of which you need to achieve. It is the center of who you are. It is the nucleus. It is the nest where all things merge and come together as one. People call it the center of the universe. And by people, I mean me. The people, like the center of the universe is you.
Me too.
Like, exactly. Meet me at the center. Meet me in the center of your authenticity. The center of the universe is you. It's just that simple.
But I love that you, like, that you just brought all that forward. Because seriously, that's the thing. Everybody thinks that authenticity is perfection. Your authenticity is all those times you used to mask up and not cry in front of people. It's allowing yourself to be vulnerable. Oh, the V word that nobody likes. Vulnerable, raw. That's your authenticity. Telling yourself, I'm tired today and I'm going to go take a nap instead of do this, this, or this is your authenticity. Because you're listening to your vessel and you're going, God, this just feels right for me today. I'm so drained. I'm physically tired. I miss this and this. Instead of, oh my God, I'm not going to mark all the boxes on my to-do list and somebody's going to be mad at me, my partner, my this, my that, my, that's your authenticity. It's showing up. And when we talk about, you know, people talk about, you know, creation and creation energy, it's creating out of inspiration and not desperation. What does that look like? What does that actually look like for you? Is that the rat race? Is that the, I have to have this, if I have to show up today because I need, or do you actually want to be there? If you don't want to be there, you're doing something inauthentic. I'm not saying you don't have bills to pay. I'm not saying that's not part of the humanness and part of the world. I'm just stating that if you have to get up and go show up, just like you said, but like show up, whether it's friends, whether it's family, whether it's a job, if you have to go show up and you're rolling your eyes and you're, oh my God, I don't want to go do this. It's too people-y there. I can't believe I'm going to go over here because, you know, these people, this, and they just drain me. You're literally going against exactly what you say your authenticity is.
Well, that's the thing. And like, that example is a good one, but it's also like a huge can of worms, because
it is. That's why I just want to go.
If you can't go somewhere because of somebody else's energy, you have a larger problem, because one, you're giving your power away and thinking that other people can have that large of effect on you. And you're also not practicing good energetic hygiene and a good sense of self, safety, security, and all these other things that would trickle into the feeling like other people can drain you that much and all this stuff, that you're almost like hiding away from your triggers instead of healing yourself so the triggers don't trigger you. Like, so that's a whole different like can of worms. But it's really important, because the example you gave, it kind of just shows how your authenticity, you're either choosing, making a decision in favor of or against your authenticity. And you can pretend there's a gray area, but there's not.
There's not.
And it's okay. And like, I feel like people need to realize this. Eventually, you are going to make a choice that disagrees with your authenticity. You're going to. And that's okay. Because if you have a reason that you cannot live without making that decision, then that in itself aligns with your authentic person in its morality code.
Yes.
And it's what I need right now. Doesn't mean it can't change later. It just means that you either make a decision that's best for you or you don't.
Correct.
And your authenticity should be what's best for your soul, because it is not separate from. So a lot of times, like that example we get all the time, especially from the people we work with, when we go live with, and like we pick up reads and things like that in private spaces, it's like, well, I don't want to have to do this, but family. Well, I want to have to do this, but my friends. I don't want to have to do this, but my job. But if this is what you are doing right now because it somewhere aligns with your authenticity and the values that you hold of yourself and things, then it does loosely align with your authenticity. But it's the knowing that you're going into the swamp or you're doing the things that you don't want to do right now. And that is extremely important, because that self-awareness is enough that it kind of takes that hindrance off the board. Now, you got to ask yourself, if you're going to places and you just playing the victim and you just drama, trauma dumping all over the place, like, you're going to have to check, because then that doesn't align for you. And you like the fact that it doesn't align, because that's part of the ego story that you're aligning with. And your ego is not you. It is the human part of you, but it is not your soul's essence. And that's important. Your authenticity is the merging of your soul and your ego, your shadow, and all those things into one. So it's a piece of your authenticity, but it's not actually the whole thing. And so I feel like that's where it kind of gets like into that like little bit of like that gray area, you know what I mean? To where people like sometimes can use it and weaponize it. And it's like, well, check yourself, you know what I mean?
But that gray area, it's, you know, I always say this, and you know this. Part of your authenticity is doing what you can live with. It's living your life without regret. Because regret will lead you back to shame. It will lead you back to guilt. It will lead you back to all of these other things.
That's 100% true.
Why are you fucking laughing?
It's 100% true. Because all I heard in my head was no regrets, not even one letter. It's just like, it's just the truth, though. Even if you make bad decisions, right? Like, you shouldn't be holding it over your head.
No.
Because you're suppressing and oppressing yourself and judging yourself all at the same time when we harbor resentment towards ourselves for our past decisions.
Yes.
You want to dampen your self-worth, your want to express your authenticity. It's by shame. It's by guilt. It's by self-imposed suffering that we adopt and like feed in our own energy inside of our own vessel, which we then project out into not only our reality, maybe project on the people around us. We start taking things too personal. And then what we end up doing is we end up anchoring ourselves in a lesser timeline. And this is perfect, you know, for the people who want to manifest things, right? Like, we end up anchoring ourselves in a lesser timeline because we start aligning with an inauthentic timeline. Because we are not aligned within ourselves. We're not aligned within the thing that we actually are, because we're shaming ourselves for being us. And that's wild. The bad decisions were also you. The like, oops moments were also you.
Yep.
The moments you regret were also you.
For you.
And it's one of those things, like, if you are going to push those aside, like, you're gonna be struggling with authenticity a lot, because you're going to be leaving a piece and a part of you out. So that means you're not going to be 100% authentic. You know what I mean? And it's coming to terms with those types of things that helps you move forward with authenticity as a whole. Because that's a piece of it. That's a piece of your shadow. It's a piece of you. And your shadow is anything you bury down, judge, and push out of the light and deem not worthy, not appropriate, not something you want to deal with, not something you want to shed light on, not things you want people to know, like, that don't have a place here. They get locked away in the shadows. That's why it's called your shadow. And that includes your regrets. That includes, you know, your self-harm. That includes all of those lesser emotions. So it's like, if you're going to start working with your authenticity, you have to realize from the get, that means working with your shadow. That means working with your problems, your troubles. That means working with your regrets, your remorses, the things you're not proud of, so that you're no longer avoiding them. So that then you can start turning some of that pain into power. You hear Keys. I mean, Keys is like the poster child for pain into power. I swear to God, every video, every time we talk, she throws it out there. It's like her saying, because she's learned how to do it, because she has already done those steps of transmuting that painful energy of remorse, regrets, bad life decisions, you know, before you knew better, and turning it into power with your do better and really harnessing and flipping that energy so it works for you. So, like, I don't know, Keys, if you want to help some people out with how to do that.
But, you know, but the, it ties back to the other things that you were saying. And I'll just use myself as the example because that can't come from me if it's me, right? I guess you probably still could.
Well, yeah.
Anyway, you know, when I always say that pain to power, I let my pain, and I say let, I let my pain be my authenticity for a really long time. I let it be the ripple for bad decisions. I let it be the mask I hid behind. And I say pain because it was really pain, but it was always something else. It was the avoiding of the pain by showing up in ways that, and when I say this, I made my pain my authenticity. This is my prime example. I can show up for somebody else the way that nobody ever showed up for me because my pain is rooted in feeling abandoned, being alone, being this, being that as a child. That's my pain. That's my pain. So I've now turned my pain into my authenticity, convincing myself that I'm being my most authentic self because I'm letting all this shit slide in my life because I'm trying to show up as this version that I wish I had until I realized that I had to give my pain a space. But that was part of the dissecting of what I wasn't, right? And when I say the dissecting of what I wasn't, I got to go all the way back to my childhood. I got to go find that part of me, right? That part of me that got told, you know, there's no crying in baseball. There's no, you know, we don't let other people, you know, see us upset. We're not vulnerable. We're not this. We're not that. Only to realize that all those emotions that I buried and I didn't give an outlet, if I actually felt them, they could then be alchemized, transmuted, transformed, whatever label you want to give it, right? Into the most beautiful kind of power because I didn't have to choose to repeat the cycles of pain because at the end of the day, they were being self-inflicted. Not saying that I, you know what I mean? We all got wounds we didn't deserve to heal from. Don't come for me in that standpoint. But when you get to a certain age, and I'm going to say it, when you get to a certain age and you begin to repeat the patterns of your pain that you haven't allowed yourself to process through, you are inadvertently burying your power. And the thing is, you know, I won't go back to something else that you said because it was just something I wanted to say anyways, but you said it in a great way. So many people talk about, I just want to go home. They don't feel at home in themselves because they're not being their authentic self. They're literally, I don't fit in here. I don't this. I don't that. So that's, but that's what you're putting out there, right? You're countering the universe. You're countering spirit. And you're going, I don't fit in here. I don't resonate with these people. I don't have this. You're so busy declaring out your mouth what you're not that the universe is giving you these things to help you discover what you are, to peel back the layers. Well, you say you're not this. So put your money where your mouth is, right? To lead you back to yourself, to your heart, to your compass, to your true north, to your nest. You feel like you're not at home because you're not sitting in spaces where you should be. You're sitting in spaces where you can't be you, where you are putting a mask on, where you are being a people pleaser, where you are doing something that so heavily rubs your energy raw that it's literally telling you this isn't where we belong. But instead of taking an action, figuring out what that actually is, you revert back into the victim mode of woe is me, I don't belong here. You can't be whole. You can't feel home in yourself. You can't have any, you can't have your, you can't experience your fullness, your authenticity, if you are still rejecting pieces and parts of yourself. Perfectly imperfect, flawed, whatever you want to say it, but you accept those things about you because that's a part of your ness. It's a part of who you are. It's your humanness. And that's the thing. Everybody wants to fight their, my soul's telling me to be here. And you're fighting your humanness in your soul. And the whole point is to have them in balance. You came here for a reason.
Now, a word from our sponsors. If you are looking for a one-stop shop for all things spiritual, check out the website, www.childofbalance.com. For those of you who truly appreciate handmade products, we have a handmade shop. Everything is made to order, blessed, saged, and sent out as quick as possible. We have anything from handmade sounds for meditation to chakra chain macrames to tree of life macrames with inlaid crystals to herbal blends like bath teas and dump and go specials to road opener mixes to kits and oils and so much more. For those of you who enjoy taking spiritual classes and courses, but maybe can't fit it into your busy schedule, we have self-study courses, and everything can be found in the handmade shop. The website is about assistance and community. Take advantage of it, fam. It's a great place to go to unlock your spiritual potential. www.childofbalance.com.
And I want to make this a rhetorical question. It must have got boring where you were at for you to want to come here and do this. Don't shoot the gift horse in the mouth because you're so busy trying to outrun your fucking humans.
And it's really funny.
Somewhere the cosmos got boring. Somewhere in whatever dimension, you know what I mean? Wherever you want, whatever. It got boring. And you're like, let's come here. Like, let's go do this. And then you're, like, chastising the experience that you came here for. You can't be authentic when you're just shaming, degrading, and dissecting and that denser, heavier judgment energy. You're the problem. It's you.
Well, and you say it all the time, Keys, that, like, your authenticity is the highest frequency level that you can be resonating at. And a lot of people will be like, well, it's love. It's divine love. Like, but, like, to love yourself is to love, like, to truly have unconditional love is through authenticity.
Yes.
Like, so it's like, just put it up next to godliness. Like, just put it up there. Like, and it's, like, really important because it's like authenticity, especially when it's from an energy standpoint, for you to be functioning off your authenticity, like 100% when you get to that point of being like authentically, you know, imperfectly me, right? Perfect. Great. You also have to have all of your elements in balance.
Yeah.
So that means your water, your fire, your earth, your ether, your air. All of that is in balance if you are functioning off of your authenticity. So when people are telling them, like themselves or others, that they need to be aligned, they need to be in balance, get in tune, like it's balance in all things.
Yes.
When you thrive in your authenticity, you are in your divine balance. You are sitting in your purpose and your divinity. In that moment, when you reach authenticity and you sit in that vibration, that second, split second that it happens, that is a moment of balance. And it's, if you're going to do anything in the universe and hope to have a balanced outcome return to you, your cause and effect, then we need to be putting out balance first to receive balance. That's why they tell you to change the inside and watch the outside change. But you can't change the inside without, one, becoming aware of the inside of you, and then, two, coming to terms with the inside of you. And coming to terms is accepting it. Coming to terms is owning responsibility. Coming to terms is releasing what's not yours, what's not in your control, what's not yours to be carrying on. It is all of those things. So as much as people want to use their fire and their passion to do their manifestation, or I want to use my feminine energy and all of her intuition or all of her emotion to manifest, and I want to pull on, no, you need to pull on all of it. And if you want to pull on all those elements, if you want to pull on like your masculine and your feminine energies, and you want to pull on all five of the energies, earth, air, fire, water, ether, or space, whatever you want to call it, or spirit, equally, that's through your authenticity. So when a lot of people tell you you're skipping steps, it's because you are. Because you're still wanting someone to hand you your authenticity outside of you. You want someone to come up with a silver platter and go, okay, you're going to do 3 jumping jacks, wave the magic wand, yell abracadabra, and you're going to have your authenticity. That's just not the case. It's because your authenticity is your blueprint. It's your fingerprint. It is so individualistically unique to you that it's like nobody else's. That's why you can discern energy. That's why when someone's energy comes in the room, you know who the hell it is. That's why then people get phone calls and be like, oh, Keys is calling me. Oh, my mother's calling me. Oh, like, it's because they're individual and they're unique. If everybody had the same authenticity, we wouldn't be able to tell people apart.
Nope.
Because it starts pulling in your soul, your energy, your lifetimes, your lineage, your life experiences on this planet, your ego, your personality, your shadow this lifetime, and all of that makes up your present moment authenticity. You need all of you. You need every piece and part of you. So anytime you go to do something, whether that be physical magic, intention work, energy work, manifesting, anything like that where you're trying to ascend, reach a timeline, using your abilities, you should do it through your authenticity. Your authenticity is like the gateway. If you want to call it a gateway drug, go for it. Because it is the one door that everybody should open that leads to the hall of doors that you can then open any other door. Like, and for my astral traveler, you know what I'm talking about? The hallway of endless doors. Like, we all been there. Like, you open it up and you're like, what the poop? And there's a million doors, because you can go any direction once you have your authenticity. Because if you're functioning in full authenticity, you're in balance. And that it's just that simple. It's just that simple. But to get to your authenticity, you have to go through your shadow. You have to go through your ego. You have to go through your pain. You have to go through your happiness. You have to go through your etherical connections. You have to go through your chakras. You have to go through, like, regardless if you do that structured or unstructured, that's your journey, and that's depending on what avenues you wish to take. But eventually, regardless of the label, you will be hitting all those things to find your authenticity. It's that self-acceptance, self-worth, you know, where I place myself, my importance. It's all of those things. So if you want to work with your abilities, if you want to manifest your dreams, if you want to do all of the steps, all the cool kids stuff, you got to go through your authenticity. And that comes with learning your ness. And finding your ness, because it is at the center of you, means uncovering the paper mache wad that you have created this lifetime of everything you're fucking not, masking, hiding away, and dimming your ness from shining. You skipping steps, kid. It's okay, because you didn't know, but now you know, so what are you going to do with it? So if you need help, guys, we teach it, we do it, because we've done it ourselves. If you need some help or guidance in finding your ness, so that you can live your authentic, unapologetic life, manifesting your dreams, having zero actual worries, because what's for you will find you, and that is the peace of mind, that is a soul's peace that you need, and then you want to play around with abilities because, like, we human this time and we like to play, like, that's perfect. But if you want to do so without frustration, without anger, without confusion, without struggle, put everything else in the back burner and figure out who the fuck you are by figuring out who the fuck you're not. Go through your door, and your door is your nest. Open your book. Your book is your soul. Open it up, because it has all the answers to you you'll ever need. And you are going to find it by reading the book, turning the handle. It's not going to be given to you by anybody else.
You're the key that opens all doors.
Because you also have the lock.
Better yet, the door is always open.
Alrighty, thank you guys so much for listening in, tuning in. Thank you for joining us on the Spiritual Roundtable, where we just really get right down in it, no BS, and we just give you exactly what you need to hear. Not always what you want to hear, but definitely what you need to hear. Thank you for joining myself and Miss Keys of Wisdoms 369 for our talk today. And we hope you join us next week, where we have more straight talk coming right your way. And if you are not a member of the website, but you enjoy conversation like this and free knowledge and learning, we have a free tree of knowledge and you should check it out. Become a member. It's 100% free and you'll find it on www.childofbalance.com. Remember, as you go through this journey, please remember you are to feel your way through everything. Do not stop. Do not make yourself smaller. And always continue to be unapologetically and authentically you. Because the world needs more of that.